Ramadan Mubarak, everybody. Some of you I know pretty well. I've been here a few times, and some of you are just getting to know. And we have with us today a nice group from the Interfaith Network in McWorth, representing Jewish, Christian, and Muslim representatives from various places, as well as some public officials. And we're so delighted for your welcome. Thank you, Imam Zahir, and to the whole masjid for making us feel so welcome, and for good food, too. You know, this is all good. So, Interfaith Network, what is it about? Interfaith work helps us to know one another, to understand one another, to build friendships. It does not try to change anybody's faith, convert anybody. It's not about arguing about who's right or who's wrong. So we have a mission statement that that explains that. The Lake Worth Interfaith Network is a group of individuals and faith-based communities dedicated to promoting acceptance and understanding among our diverse spiritual traditions. So it recognizes the diversity among us as a beautiful thing. It's something we can learn from each other and to enjoy one another because of the differences that are between us. So I'd like to talk a little bit about what interfaith dialogue is as a way of enhancing mutual compassion. I know in the Muslim tradition it's very important, the Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, right? And this means that God is merciful and kind, compassionate, and understanding. So we, with a warm embrace, embrace each of you tonight. So the purpose of interfaith dialogue is to know ourselves more deeply and enrich and round out our faith by learning about other people. So the more we learn about how other people express their faith, the more we think about, why do we do this the way we do it? And we become deeper in our own faith because of the dialogue with each other. So we help each other to grow in our faith that way. Second purpose is to know each other more authentically and gain a friendly understanding of the others and to eliminate prejudice. Prejudice is something that happens when we judge people before we know them. Free judging. So we say, oh, I know all about you kind of people. I know all about you. I don't have to know anything more. I can tell by your clothes. I can tell by your skin. I can tell by your accent. I can tell by something. What kind of person you are. This is prejudice. What we want to do is eliminate this so that we treat each other as individuals made in the image of God and really respect one another. And the third purpose is to identify commonly held values, what things we share in common, that provides a basis for united community action. So there's so much that needs to be done in our community to help the poor, to bring justice about, and these are things that that all faiths share, and that we can work on together, and the more we know one another, we build projects, and God willing, inshallah, we will help to make our community a beloved community. So I would like to just take a minute to introduce some people that have come from very far away. I think many of you have met Sheikh Ghassan Manasarai. He came from Sarasota now. His wife just joined him with 2 weeks ago. Where is Layla? Would you raise your hand? There you go. And along with them, Katie is an intern at the Abrahamic Reunion in Sarasota. And Anna, there you are. She came along with them. She has a very rich spiritual background. I wish you had a chance to speak to her too. And who am I missing, Chris? Who has been here before as well. And the other person who has come a long way, who represents, you'll hear from him a little bit later, he represents the United States Department of Justice. And Norman Hemming came all the way from Miami tonight, right, to be with us. So we appreciate that special effort. So I want to conclude on a positive note with something from the Baha'i writing. So powerful is the light of unity that it can illuminate the whole world. Yet shall it be these fruitless strifes. When we think about the bad things that have been happening in Orlando, San Bernardino, France, and different places. These fruitless strifes, these ruinous wars shall pass away, and the most great peace shall come. Let it begin here.